Hi, my name is Glenn Gould. I play Sirsqua Shunali Tiganaugiski, chief bird who sings early in the morning of the Cherokee tribe. So I'm going to take you for a little walk through our set here. And the accuracy of the set that they took time to do the research, and they've done everything pretty accurately here, which is really nice because it's like stepping back in time. We have some of my people here. These are probably my wives. This is our main council chambers behind us that I just came out of. It's quite a treat to be here in Scotland shooting Outlander. We're going to take a little stroll through here and take a little walk through the village. It's really, really nice here. The setting is just amazing and wonderful. They've done a stellar job on the sets here and just on everything. It's just so amazing. The accuracy of everything here in the village. We've got corn. It's not real corn, but it looks pretty real. We've got all of our community members here, people, members of our Cherokee tribe, Cherokee Nation. Here, let's take you for a little walk through these cornfields here. It's quite amazing. There's lots here. The dwellings, everything is so accurate, just amazing. They've done an amazing job here. It's like stepping back in time, you know. I'm sure, like, it would have been something else to live in these times way back when, 200-300 years ago. Everything would have been just so communal. Everybody would have taken care of themselves in the community. They would have taken care of each other and helped each other. These are not Cherokee people behind me. But they love the Cherokee. I can't stop. I'm talking on it's part of the virtual tour. So we've got some fire pits here. Of course, the fire pits are all fed by propane. Here's probably one of our traders' places right here. So there's lots of belts and stuff that would have been traded goods. You can see there's some game there, some deer. But the setting here is just outstanding. It's just amazing. We're so lucky, so blessed to be a part of this production and, you know, stellar job. So hats off to set design and set deck, and the art department did an amazing job here on all the sets. They're pretty accurate. Here's the central fire pit over here behind me, which is pretty cool. And that's pretty neat over there. That looks like it could be a sweat lodge. And there we go. So take a walk through here. Yeah, it's quite something else here. So, it's just really nice. There's a lot of dream catchers here, which kind of reminds me of Red Dead Redemption 2, doing the dream catcher mission. I feel like catching all these dream catchers and collecting them. So again, this is some more of my people here, some Cherokees. Hello, hello, hello. Cherokees everywhere. And of course, there's people from all across the country here. We've got people from the Northwest Territories in Canada, to British Columbia, Alberta, Quebec. We've got Squamish, Cree, Dene, Haudenosaunee, Mi'kmaq, Anishinaabe. We got all the nations represented here, all representing their nations, and Nakoda as well. We got Nakoda as well. So we've got all kinds of nations here from right across the country of Canada, coast to coast. It's really nice to see, and we're portraying Cherokee. So I hope you enjoyed this little walkthrough of our of our village. Yes, and they had eyeglasses. And some of these guys, they really took the time, you know. They shaved half of their heads, some of these guys. And this guy shaved half of his head over there. He had long hair. That's all his real hair. And that's what you call commitment right there, right? Yeah, and those sunglasses are total period. Everybody's got shades on, just looking rock and roll. So this is it. Down by the riverside over here. Let's take a walk down by the river. So there's actually fish jumping in this river. There was a big salmon we saw come out of this river the other day. That was something else. It was pretty huge. All the Indians here got excited when we saw that fish jump out of the water. This is our big daddy right here. And this is the shore, the shoreline of Chief Bird, who sings early in the morning. This is his village, and this is the shoreline. There's a nice dock over here. We'll go see what's happening with these guys. This is where the canoes would have been built, and any carvings or any things would have been made. And then over here, this is the fishing area where all the nets and all that, and the canoes, all that stuff. All these canoes, which are pretty accurate to look like they came from back in the time in the day. And yeah, it's pretty neat, pretty cool stuff here. So there's some apples being cooked over the fire there, and some geese, some salmon, and that's it. And here we have the entire village. Okay, thank you so much. The Cherokee village right here in Scotland, which is pretty fabulous. They did a stellar job. So thank you. Thank you for joining me on this walk. It was a pleasure to take you through Chief Tsisquashinali Diganogiski, right here, Chief Bird, who sings early in the morning. Glenn Gould, have a nice day.